Hey, this is DJ from DJSTRAINS on YouTube, and I'm with my daughter Morgan, and we are freezing this winter. It is the perfect weather to be inside in a nice warm house working on the model train layout. And I'm going to show you a video of my train layout. We need to get somewhere warmer. Let's make it summer. You ready? One, two, three. Good job. Let's go swimming.
Outside of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, looking down from the Route 22 bridge in Monroeville, you'll see the engine facilities of the Union Railroad. This 7-bay diesel house was built in the early 1950s, and I'm scratch building it from styrene. Although the area is far from finished, all 7 doors are removable and the tracks inside do work. The Union Railroad's stable of EMD MP15s and SW1500s are kept here when not in use. Engine number 25, an Atlas MP15, is headed towards the turntable. He'll be part of a 3-unit consist for today's coal train. The 15-stall roundhouse is visible only from a hill, so I made the edge of my layout the same. I will be scratch building the roundhouse, but for now, let's take a look at the Kato turntable. The control is currently under the layout. It works for DC and DCC, but to avoid shorts with my DCC system, here's what I have done. Coming from my track's power supply, I ran a wire to an auto reverser, and then from there into the Kato controller. This way I can have the direction switch in either position, and it won't trip, and the turntable is constantly powered. So now engine 25 has done a complete 180 degree, and instead of tripping the whole DCC system, the auto reverser takes over, and I continue on my way. If it backed into the turntable, the reverse stays the same. The turntable has auto indexing, so it lines up perfectly every time. Wiring it this way allows for whatever track it stops at becomes powered. There it stopped at the track with the green engine on it, and that track became powered. The bridge is always powered. And then whenever I move the bridge, that track that it was on is no longer powered. If you wanted all those tracks in the roundhouse to be powered at all times, the best way to do it is to put plastic rail joiners between the track and the turntable. Underneath each track is a spot where you can wire, they have an adapter kit, you can wire each one of those tracks individually. Now we're going to line up to our lead unit here. This is engine 31. Unlike most turntables where you have to cut a hole in the benchwork, this is a turntable that's only 3/8 of an inch high. You can run it on a carpet. The problem it posed for me is I have to raise the ground up to meet it because I wanted everything flush. I have other tracks going in. So I use 3/8 thick foam board. It has a cardboard backing on it. And I'm going to smooth it all out with sculpt mold. So there are pros and cons, but I love this turntable. It's fantastic. And yes, the Union does run this way with the cab facing the direction of travel because they have that big window which allows better visibility. After making a consist with my NCE system, we pull out onto the southbound main. Number 31 is our leader for today. I'm going to hand line the switches back, and we're going to head south on the southbound track. The first thing that we'll go across is a lift out. We'll show that a little later. But let's come into our first scenic area underneath the Westinghouse Bridge. And you notice the Conrail tracks. The Union in the background. After passing under the Westinghouse Bridge, going across a truss bridge, there's a switch that drops down to the right towards Edgar Thompson, but we're going to go straight and head to Duquesne to get our coal. This scene was modeled on a video called How to Get Rid of That Flat Look. As the train's getting ready to pass Edgar Thompson, you'll notice the scratch belt open hearts. Still some more work to do, but it looks a lot like the prototype. At this point, the double track turns into single track to go across the Port Perry Bridge. The other track on the bridge is for going from the mill to Homestead. This area is called Port Perry. You're looking at the double track of the Chessy system. The track to the right is also for the Union, but all those three tracks are dummy tracks, are unpowered. Up on the bridge, a unit has a bottle car, and here comes our consist. To the left is the Monongahela River and the big Port Perry Bridge. This area is called the Duquesne Wharf. From here, barges of coal get unloaded onto waiting rail cars. The Whirly Bird crane is doing all the work in 1987. I still have to build a couple more buildings for this area, but our light power is going to a three-track yard where it's going to pick up a load of coal. All right, we're going to tie onto this load of coal. It's only 10 cars and a caboose right now. This area, if you remember one of my videos about making background scenery, it looks so good. And it's coming along. There used to be a huge steel mill here, but it closed before the 1987 time period that I'm modeling. Right now they store a lot of pipe down there. So I'll work on this probably in the next few months. The track up on the hill is the main line that goes to McKeesport. I put a little two-track staging yard there. And then we're going to pull out with our 10 loaded hopper cars. Most of the cars I saw back in 1987 were all for the Bessemer and Lake Erie. And every train does have a caboose, because in a lot of areas they would shove or they would do a three-point turn on Y's. So they were using those bay window cabooses. As our train heads back north, you'll notice the car shops in the background. And this is just a small sample of the big car shops that they had in a valley. The valley is right next to Kennywood, if you've ever been to Pittsburgh. They built a lot of their own cars and cabooses at the car shops. So I wanted to model this. This lift-out section has a double-track crossover. And now we're crossing over to the northbound main. Here you see the Route 22 bridge, and our train is heading north up to North Bessemer, where it'll interchange with the Bessemer and Lake Erie. I've only started some of the scenery in this area, but keep watching these videos because it's going to be done before you know it. And here's the latest addition. Now I have a continuous loop, which I'm so excited. It's going to go all the way around. This whole thing is going to be scenic one day. It's going to have big yard staging. It's going to connect onto McKeesport over a bridge back towards Duquesne. I'll have my modeling desk underneath it. And I'll try to give you an example. I know, sorry about the shaky camera. Here we go. Woo! All right, and back to where we started from. All right, so that's a brief tour. I hope you enjoyed it. Please check out my website, djstrains.com. Follow me on Twitter and on Facebook, and I have a lot more videos coming, a lot of cool stuff. I'm promising some great stuff. And if you noticed, somewhere along the line, I derailed. Where's my caboose? Oh, shit.